Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to this edition of Programming Users. Guys, for today we're going to see how to download an image from the web and display in an image view. We shall be downloading an image asynchronously, okay, using AsyncTask. So guys, this is what we're talking about. Right now I have my SQL running. So guys, this is my test website. Actually, you can see it's just hosted locally, okay? Now, the image you want to download is this particular image right here. This is the image that you want to. So the first thing we shall get its location. Now, this is the image you want to download from this particular website right here, okay? So what I'll come and do, if I just click a download button, you can see it will download it. I don't know if you've seen it, but first it will show us a progress dialog while it fetches that particular image. Very first it will show progress dialog, fetches that image and displays it, okay? So guys, it's just a simple tutorial to show you how to download an image from the web asynchronously. So guys, welcome, we get started. Obviously, the first thing that we're going to do, please create your Android application project right here. I've already created my project. You can see my main activities right here. Then for my activity layout, actually I've pre-designed mine. This is just a simple image view. This is just a simple image view, actually with an image that I just added from my machine, okay? It's just this particular image right here. It's just a simple image view. And then right here we have our download button. So when the download button is clicked, we shall fetch that particular image from the web. So please first, of course, just design your layout. Then right here, the first thing, we shall create a variable that is going to hold for us the URL for the image. So I'll just call it a URL, okay? By the way, if you, let's just have a look right here, you can see this is the image that I said that I wanted to download. Obviously, if you want to get the URL for the image, just right click it, then copy image location, okay? That one shall give you, shall give us the location for that particular URL. Like for me, in my case, if I bring it right here, this is, if I come and paste it right here, actually this is my image location .jpg, okay? So this is the image. But now guys, I want you to take note of something. Like for me, actually I'm using actually my website is located, is hosted locally, okay? I'm using a local host right here. So because we're using localhost, we are not just going to use right here in this URL. Please just come and replace this one with the 10.0.0. Okay, no, 10.0.0.2.2. Okay, no, just pass this particular address. This one shall act as the address. Please replace it with the local host, or else it won't work, okay? So just have it right there. Once you've done that one, of course we shall also need to declare our image view. I'll just have it right there as img. Then for our button, I'll just call it download btn. Then for the progress dialog, so progress dialog, I'll just declare it as PD. Then we're going to reference this stuff. So img equal to find view by id r.id, then .imageview1, then we cast it to image view. Okay, that shall give us our image view. Then for download button, we'll do the same. Download button equal to find view by id r.id dot actually it's just button, then we cast it to button, okay? Then now what is going to happen is very simple. When the download button is clicked, we're going to, let's just handle its own click listener. So when the download button is clicked, we're simply going to download our stuff, okay? So just when it is clicked, then right here we shall download our stuff. But remember, we want to do this one asynchronously in the background, in a background thread. So very first, you're just going to create an inner class that is going to help us do so. So private, let's just come and create the class right here. Private class, let me call it a downloader. Okay, downloader. Then of course you're going to inherit from AsyncTask. So extends AsyncTask. Okay, so we inherit from AsyncTask right here. I just pass a string. Okay, then after string void and bitmap. Void a bitmap. So this is our inner class. This class is going to be responsible for downloading for us our stuff in the background. This one should be class, of course. Then it shall request to implement at least one particular method. Right there we're going to implement our bitmap. Now our doing background, you can see it shall be returning this particular bitmap. Now when once it has returned this particular bitmap, we shall pass the bitmap to our on post execute. So let's just come right here and also override the, so now what is this, and override the on post execute method right here. Okay, so you can see at the bitmap from our doing background shall be passed right there, and then that is where we are going to be set it. We shall set it to our image view. But in fact, let's also just come right here and also override the on pre-execute. So guys, what happens is that when in this class, the first thing that happens, the on pre-execute method is first called before the actual work in the background starts. Then that particular heavy operation is done inside our doing in background method. Then the doing background method shall return this particular bitmap that we specified right here. Okay, so once it has returned it, it shall return it to our on post execute method, which shall take it, and then it is right here that we are going to set it to our image view. So actually inside our own pre-execute, what we're going to do, we're just going to create our progress bar dialog and then set its properties. Okay, so let's just come pd, which is our progress dialog, equal to new progress dialog. Then for the context, we're going to pass a main activity dot this. Okay, the context of the context. Now after that one, obviously we shall also set the title pd.setTitle, the title for our progress dialog. For me, I'll just call it image downloader. Okay, that shall be my title, image downloader. This shall be the title for my progress dialog. Then obviously we're also going to set the message. Now for the message, I'll just come pd dot set message. Then for my message, I'll just have there downloading, just a simple message. That shall be the message that shall be displayed inside our progress dialog. Then we're going to set it its indeterminate property to false. Pd dot set in determinate, then we pass there a false. Okay, so then lastly, of course it is a progress dialog, so we have to show it. So come and just call the show method. So guys, that's our pre-execute. Just as I've said, this method is called before we start the actual work in the background. Then when the work in background starts, it, of course it shall be done right here inside our do in background. So this one, actually this is the URL that shall be passed right here inside our do in background method. Then what we're going to do, just come right here and say string. I'll call it my URL. Okay, equal to URL 0, the first item that shall be passed right there in our parameter. Then we're going to create a bitmap object. So bitmap call it bm equal to null. You just initialize it to null. Now inside the try catch block, we're going to download our stuff using an input stream object. So come right here, let's catch this particular exception, catch exception e dot print stack trace. So right here, let's just create an input stream object. So input stream, I'll just call it is, okay, equal to then new URL, then we pass there our URL. Of course our URL right here is this is my URL that we shall be passing right there, okay. Then we call it open stream method. So just have there my URL dot open stream, okay. Then once we have it right there, we're going to decode it. Actually this one should not be URI, this one should be URL, okay. So decode. Now to decode is very simple. What we're going to see, in fact actually we're going to assign it to a bitmap object. So just come right here and say bitmap, then bitmap factory, okay, dot decode. We call this decode method, okay, dot decode stream. So this one decode stream, and then we pass our input stream right there. Of course shall decode it and return for us a bitmap object which we are going to assign to our BM right there. Obviously it is that bitmap that we're going to return. So actually it shall be in fact we just write here bitmap BM. Now it shall be returned and passed to our own post execute method right here. So what we're going to do right here, we're just going to set it to our image view. So let's just come right here and then just come and say img, which is our image view dot set image bitmap, then we pass of course the result that shall be passed right there, okay. This one shall return pass shall set that particular bitmap to our image view. Then obviously this we're going to dismiss our progress dialog. So pd dot dismiss, obviously after the work is done. So guys, that's it. That's how simple it is to download an image from the web. In fact let's now just run our no before this one. Of course we need to come and call the instance of our downloader, okay. So just come right here and say new downloader, okay, our downloader which of course is inheriting from AsyncTask. Then we call this execute method, then we pass the URL. Now for us in our case the URL we have specified right there, so I'll just pass it right there. And that's it guys. Let's just run our project and have a look. So ladies and gentlemen, here is our program. Please take note that you have to be connected to a server. Either you have to be online, or if you're using you're hosting your server locally, okay, your server has to be running. Like for me, I'm using one server with my SQL. So if I come click right here, download, you can see very fast our progress bar gets shown, and then it downloads our image and display it, okay. It connects to the server, downloads the image and displays right here, okay. So if you come very fast, it shows our dialog and downloads our image. This does it. It has been such a simple tutorial, but we've seen how to download an image asynchronously in the background, okay. So if you've loved the tutorial, just hit the subscribe button so that you continue to see tutorial like this ones on a regular basis. Like this video and share it with friends and family, okay. And please take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.